Now on Coast TV News.
Keeping paws away from the produce, the future of dogs at the historic Lewis Farmers Market. Plus, get your phones ready. This is going to be part of our Coast TV poll.
Plus, the future of Lewis, the other issues that he decided on tonight, and how that could shape the first town.
A Milford neighbor taking on the city, why people are coming together over an eminent domain case.
And must-see video, multiple car chases, deflation devices. We have the details on what led to this wild arrest.
And it looks like the weather's going to be wild. Next, the ebb, flow, and forecast threat. Understanding the surge of coastal waters and the implication for residents near waterways.
This is Coast TV News at 11.
Demanding action. People in Milford heated as the city tries to take over this land through eminent domain. Good evening, I'm Charlie Sakaitis.
And I'm Mallory Metzner. Welcome to our news at 11. We begin tonight with the people of Milford taking to City Hall.
A woman named Annette Billings is currently in a legal battle with the city of Milford. The city wants to use eminent domain on her property.
But tonight we learned that Billings has a lot of friends, or at least a lot of supporters to her cause.
Coast TV's Charles Reinert shows us why people are so fired up over this controversial case.
Signs like this one held high at Milford City Hall Monday night, as countless people packed the chamber to show their support for Annette Billings.
If this was a Hallmark movie, you'd be the bad guys.
Even some of the politicians on hand, like State Senator Eric Wilson, made comments in defense of Billings.
Would anyone on this council, would you like to have someone come along and knock on your door and say, eminent domain, we need your prop? Let's be realistic.
Billings owns this land off of South Rehoboth Boulevard, but the city wants to take 8 acres through eminent domain in order to build bike lanes, and they're offering her just $20,000.
But when you see that the city wants to put something like a bike path there or like a park, and you've said you've owned that land for so long, like when you picture something like that on that land, like how does it make you feel now?
It's depressing. They've got bike paths everywhere, and I never see anybody riding their bikes on them.
The city condemned the property back in September, but Billings says the property is worth a lot more than what the city's offering.
I reached out to every single member of the Milford City Council today for a comment on this, and the ones that got back to me declined. I also reached out to Milford Mayor Archie Campbell today for a comment, and he told me that since this is now a legal issue, that he can no longer speak about it.
Billings does have a lawyer and is hoping to get the ruling overturned, and says the support from the community means so much to her.
I cannot believe this, all the support that is being focused on this right now, and as it should be.
For now, all Billings can do is state her case, rally her supporters, and hope she gets some help, be it through her lawyer or the heavy sway of public opinion. According to Billings, the court trials begin this week. I'm Charles Reinert in Milford, Coast TV News.
Breaking news tonight, after days evading authorities and multiple high-speed escapes, a 25-year-old Delmar man by the name of Mark Brown was caught by police in Dagsboro, and we have harrowing video footage of the moment that happened. Take a look at your screen here, and you're going to be able to see police taking a man to the ground, or eventually you'll be able to see it. We're going to show it to you in slow-mo as well here in a second. What you'll see in the video is a truck actually hits the man that we believe is Mark Brown, knocks him to the ground, and then he gets up and a number of officers converge on Brown, bringing him down. But this is just the ending to a much longer story. Excuse me, folks. According to Bethany Beach Police, this all started last Tuesday on February 6th in South Bethany when the driver of a 2013 Dodge Avenger took off after a traffic stop. Police stopped chasing the car, deeming it unsafe, but they issued what was called a BOLO, or be on the lookout for that car. Later that day, the same car escaped police again. And then last Wednesday, February 7th, that same vehicle got away from South Bethany PD after racking up a number of traffic violations. Then a break. Police learned that the car had been sold to an unknown person just a week prior, and authorities were actually able to use Ring Cam door footage to circulate what the driver looked like. And that gets us back to today, February 12th. The car was spotted a little before noon in Bethany Beach. A man matching the description from the Ring camera was working construction at a nearby house. And again, that driver, believed to be Mark Brown, took off, reportedly on State Road 26 at more than 100 miles per hour. Other officers had been alerted, and eventually Dagsboro police managed to disable the car with a deflation device, all leading us back to the video at Dagsboro Road and 113 just south of Millsboro, where ultimately Delaware State Police and Ocean View PD took Brown into custody. Talk about a whirlwind. Brown was discovered that he had been facing 8 felony warrants already from Sussex County Superior Court, 1 warrant from the Department of Corrections. We do not have the official charges yet from this incident, but a post from Bethany Beach claims he's being charged by numerous agencies.
And now let's take a live look outside into Salisbury as we check on the weather here. You can see it's looking kind of gray there with all of those lights there above the university. I did hear some rain on our roof here in Milton. So let's check in with our First Alert Chief Meteorologist Paul Williams.
Well, you know what, Mallory? Yeah, the rain is dancing on the roof and it's going to be dancing on the street, and then it's going to start stomping all over the place about 4 o'clock this morning when most of us are asleep, because heavy rain's heading our way. Our tidal health camera in Seaford indicating we're at 42 degrees. Winds are out of the north. Temperatures are going to stay in the low 40s, and we are looking for intermittent scattered showers throughout the night with cloud cover staying a bit on the thick side. Now, there's an actual storm headed in our direction, a winter storm, but we're on the warm side of that storm, so we're dealing with coastal flood warnings here. I had a very interesting email that somebody was sending me, questioning me about this. Why is this becoming such a problem for an extended period of time? To be honest, it actually may have a lot to do with the warming of the polar ice caps, because the water levels are going up, folks. That's the short answer. And our short answer coming up is that this is going to be a problem for us for the next 24 hours. We'll talk more about it coming up in a moment. So then back to you, Mallory.
Thank you, Paul. And new tonight, dogs might not always be welcome inside the historic Lewis Farmers Market. City Council voted unanimously to accept the market's request to change its permit. The organization may now allow dogs on leashes no longer than 6 feet. It also has the authority to put up signs indicating when dogs are not allowed in the vendor area of George H. P. Smith Park. Certified service dogs are always allowed.
I had no idea the issue that we had at the dogs. I thought it was just a matter of we just didn't want to deal with it. But when I read all the stories, everything from the children and urinating on the food stuff.
Again, the farmers market is not banning dogs. It has the authority to prohibit them from entering the part of George H. P. Smith Park that its vendors are set up in when it becomes a health or safety concern.
And that's going to bring us right into the Coast TV poll. We want to know, should dogs be banned at the Lewis Farmers Market? Earlier tonight, it was heavily in favor of yes. Let's see if that's changed at all.
Look at your screen here. It looks like 74% do say yes, maybe citing some of those health concerns that the market was saying when there's a lot of dogs present at once. 25% say no. 1% want to treat it case by case. Again, if there's only one dog coming to the market at a time, maybe that's okay. If there's 100, like the market told me, maybe there's a concern.
That would be a lot. Now, if you haven't voted yet, if you have a big opinion on this, go to CoastTV.com or use our CoastTV mobile app. And new tonight, the Lewis line has reached the end of the line. In a 3-2 vote, the mayor and city council voted to discontinue the pilot program. One council person noted that the Lewis line might be needed more once the Dart Beach Route 204 goes from running every 30 to every 50 minutes, but reasons cited for ending it include the cost of maintenance and ridership, as well as low rider turnout.
Why are the taxpayers putting forward money to support moving the tourists around town? This is not supported.
Can I answer that?
Yes.
I think I mentioned two areas are local businesses on Second Street who have expressed a lot of support for this.
The summer is the third and final year of the Lewis Line pilot program.
The next step for the proposed 79-lot Henlopen Bluff development off Gills Neck Road is for it to go back to the Lewis Planning and Zoning Commission. The mayor and city council making that decision on a number of conditions tonight. However, another major subdivision down the street is moving forward. Council voted to unanimously approve the White's Pond Preserve site plan and site improvements, saying the 13 single-family lot development along Monroe Avenue Extended meets code requirements.
It was one of the first subdivisions that went through the new planning process, so I appreciate the applicants going through that. And I think people found it to be, you know, a good way of getting at some of these areas where they might find some compromise.
Don't forget, if you want more on our weather updates, make sure to pull out your phones and scan the QR code for our First Alert weather app. You can download the app for free to get all the weather updates you need. Former President Donald Trump is facing a new blowback for a shocking remark he made at a rally in South Carolina over the weekend.
Mr. Trump said he would encourage Russia to do whatever they want to any NATO member country that didn't meet the alliance's funding guidelines.
As Julia Benbrook reports, that statement has been met with swift criticism from the other presidential candidates.
At a rally over the weekend, former President Donald Trump said he would encourage Russia to do what they want to any NATO country that did not meet its defense spending targets.
And one of the presidents of a big country stood up and said, "Well, sir, if we don't pay and we're attacked by Russia, will you protect us?" I said, "You didn't pay? You're delinquent?" He said, "Yes, let's say that happened. No, I would not protect you. In fact, I would encourage them to do whatever the hell they want."
NATO has a target that each member country spends a minimum of 2% of gross domestic product on defense. While most countries are not meeting that target, the figure is a guideline and not a binding contract. The former president's comments received immediate pushback from many, including his political opponents.
Putin kills his opponents. He invades free countries. This is not someone you ever want to pal around with, and you certainly don't want to give them the right to invade a friend.
In a statement, President Joe Biden called Trump's comments appalling and dangerous. But some congressional Republicans are defending the former president.
Virtually every American president at some point in some way has complained about other countries in NATO not doing enough. Trump's just the first one to express it in these terms.
Reporting in Washington, I'm Julia Benbrook.
And new tonight, another story surrounding former President Donald Trump. He's asking the U.S. Supreme Court to get involved in yet another election-related issue. On Monday, Mr. Trump requested the high court to temporarily block a unanimous decision from the D.C. Circuit that rejected his immunity claims from the election subversion charges that he's facing from special counsel Jack Smith. The Supreme Court response to the request will play a factor on when and or if Trump will go to trial for federal criminal charges. Meanwhile, just last week, the Supreme Court heard an argument on whether or not Trump should be taken off the 2024 ballot in Colorado due to his alleged actions prior to the January 6th siege on the U.S. Capitol.
We are thrilled to announce that CoastTV has a brand new Facebook page. For the latest in news, exclusive content, and interactive discussions, make sure to visit and follow our new page. Just head over to facebook.com/CoastTVNBC or scan the QR code on your screen. Stay connected with us.
Some big stories in that first block, but we have more on the docket.
Wawa Where? A proposal for a new gas station. We'll let you know if it's in your area.
And coming up, a chill and spill synopsis, how the cold and the rain could combine for hazardous conditions for you tomorrow morning.
Filling a shopping cart with essentials, why the Milford Food Bank is seeing an increase in visitors at the pantry. We're going to be back in just 60 seconds.
On Coast Life, don't miss a special evening of drama with a free staged reading of Love Letters, a Pulitzer Prize finalist. Plus, is listening to music while working productive or distracting? Tomorrow at 4 on Coast TV.
At Atlantic General Hospital, we've been busy. Busy expanding healthcare services that are second to none in our region. From cancer care, women's health services, to orthopedics, gastroenterology, and more, we provide advanced health technologies delivered by top providers. Expert care every day. It's what you can count on from Atlantic General Hospital.
Delmarva's Classic Rock, Big 107.7.
This is Coast TV News at 11.
From chicken noodle soup to mac and cheese, volunteers at the Food Bank of Delaware in Milford, they are in a hurry to stock shelves as they see more and more people walking through their doors in need of food.
As Coast TV's Tori Seagrave shows us, the food bank has seen an almost 50% increase since moving to the new facility.
Nora Mastrosimone has spent the last year stocking shelves at the Food Bank of Delaware in Milford so that those in need can roll through the aisles and fill their carts.
It gives them so much more of a choice of what they need. They can pick and choose as if they're walking through Redner's or Food Lion. It gives them more dignity that they're coming here to shop.
Mastrosimone prides herself in helping neighbors on a one-on-one basis pick out items from the Healthy Pantry Center. A lot of times are people she has come to know, but recently she says she's noticed a big increase in new faces. The numbers back that up. The food bank has gone from serving 300 people in 24 hours to 444 people since moving to the new facility about a month ago.
Food is very expensive.
According to the bank, layoffs and seasonal workers account for the majority of new shoppers.
It just gives them that option here to be able to save a little bit of money and be able to help them.
But feeding more mouths requires more helping hands.
There's a huge need for more volunteers. So if that could ever happen, we can always use the help. So volunteers are a very big part of what we do, and we need them.
Helping address hunger in the Milford community, one cart at a time.
Besides food, the Milford Food Bank is looking for donations of reusable bags for people coming to use the pantry. I'm Tori Seagraves in Milford, Coast TV News.
We're concerned about a winter storm paying us a visit, coming knocking on our door late tonight, going into the early morning hours, which is why it's a great idea to take out the time to put your phone on camera and scan the QR code so you can have access to our absolutely free app so you can keep track of what's going on in your neighborhood, Johnny on the spot. Now, our Hershey's exterior camera right now in Ocean City really indicating there are tremendous amount of moisture we can see hovering in the background there. But as far as our forecast for the rest of the evening is concerned, we're going to stay in the mid-40s, mostly cloudy skies, kind of damp, if not damp, just flat out rainy. By the way, if this QR code is a little too intimidating for you, it's okay. We also made sure that we also provided weather a phone call away for you. You simply call 443-880-9100. That way your forecast is just a phone call away, and it's sponsored by Baird, Mandela's, Brockstead, and Federico. Now, we have a coastal flood warning in effect for all of Sussex. It stays in effect at the very least until 3 o'clock in the morning. Low level and low lying areas prone for flooding. You've already been threatening flooding in your area all of last week. And now that we have rain and on top of that, of course, that just simply exacerbated the problem. That rain activity is moving its way towards the northeast, moving at about 15 to 20 miles per hour with gale wind watches off of the Prime Hook Beach coast. But then off of Indian Beach, Bottom Hills, right along Highway 1, we have a gale wind warning. Warnings indicating watching out for 40 mile per hour winds. Wind advisory inland, we're watching out about for 35 mile per hour winds, more inland. That's part of the concern. And then, of course, we have additional coastal flood concerns in Dorchester, Somerset, and Wicomico. Once again, low-lying areas for those cities that are near bays or along the coast. Here's that swath of precipitation that's moving its way towards us. We have winter warnings and watches to our north. We're on the warm side of this thing thus far. This low-pressure system is going to swing out to the water, and this is where it is right now. It's going to swing out towards the water, and the backside of it is going to combine with cold air and give us a smidgen of snow, but it's going to be too warm on the ground for the snow to stick around. 42 in Lewis, Milton, Rehoboth, Bethany Beach, and Georgetown. Here's a look at that rain. You see, by 10 o'clock, we see the snow coming through. but we're above freezing during the day. And then it's gone before the sun is gone. So it won't have a chance to freeze and stick around the snow, but it's going to make the streets wet. So we go into Wednesday morning, we're going to drop down into the 30s, so it'll be cold enough for it to freeze. And see, we're going to get about an inch or so or more, so we're going to have some puddling that will occur. That, along with the winds coming out of the north, particularly at about 41 miles per hour, it's going to make for a cold mess. Oh, one more quick thing, and I'm wrapping it up right now. We're watching out for a hard freeze after the rain gets out of the way by Thursday and continuing on. 40 for tonight with showers. Tomorrow morning, we have a first alert morning. Wednesday, it's cold in the morning time there as well, so get ready for it. Here's a look at your exclusive Paul Davis Restoration and Home Remodeling extended forecast.
Thank you, Paul. Coming up next, the cost of cocoa going up. How that could put a pinch in the pocket of everyone buying sweet treats for Valentine's Day.
Simplify your kitchen with a pull-out trash can, organized spice rack, or sliding shelves.
At Paul Davis, we designed your kitchen to work with your life.
And Paul Davis won't tear out your kitchen, so you don't have to worry about months of disruption, and you'll save money.
Instead, let us reface your kitchen cabinets in the latest style and color in just 3 days.
Right now, Paul Davis is offering free installation with no money down, no payments, and no interest for 12 months. Call Paul Davis for a free estimate.
We'll come see you as soon as tomorrow or visit our new showroom in Salisbury.
The Ford President's Day sales event is here. Time to save on Ford F-150 with 1.9% financing for 72 months. Designed to give you impressive power and innovative tech. Plus, complimentary pickup and delivery with your scheduled maintenance. Don't miss the President's Day sales event and the savings going on now. Get 1.9% financing for 72 months on Ford F-150 only at your local Ford dealer.
The job of a Delaware Electric Cooperative employee is dangerous, but the biggest threat our team faces may come from you. Drivers are putting our crews in danger, speeding past line workers while they restore power. Help our co-op employees return home to their families at the end of the day. Slow down or move over when you see utility employees and first responders working along area roads. It's not just the right thing to do, it's also the law. Stay safe, stay vigilant, move over, and slow down.
The President's Day sales event is here at Preston Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram of Millsboro.
The Dodge Hornet RT is the most powerful compact utility vehicle. Lease one for 2 years at just $299 per month with only $39.95 due at signing. With every new purchase, you'll get our Preston for Life lifetime engine guarantee. View our complete selection online at MillsboroCDJR.com. Don't miss the amazing deals right here at the President's Day sales event at Preston Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram of Millsboro. Cars cost less with Preston.
Cocoa prices are surging so high, even the biggest chocolate makers are struggling to stay profitable. And that doesn't bode well for your wallet this Valentine's Day, does it? West Africa is home to more than 60% of global cocoa production. Climate issues there are damaging crop yields, hurting the cocoa supply, and causing prices to soar. Hershey said Thursday it would cut 5% of its workforce after historic cocoa prices and inflation-weary customers dampened fourth-quarter earnings.
Berlin could get a new Wawa. The town is planning, the Planning Commission is set to review a site plan revision of the new store on Main Street. Commissioners will meet this Wednesday at 5:30 p.m. at the town hall. And DelDOT invites the Bridgeville and Greenwood communities to a public workshop aimed at shaping the future of transportation in the area. The open house event is going to gather public insights, public ideas. It's a key step in developing a comprehensive, long-range transportation plan that aligns with community goals, focusing on safety and economic development. The workshop will be held at Woodbridge High School cafeteria. That is from 4 to 6 p.m. on February 23rd. Coming up in sports, Delmarva Christian boys basketball hoping to stay near the top of the conference, but Saints Peter and Paul looking to spoil their fun.
And next, clean up everybody everywhere, why Fenwick Island wants your help on Earth Day.
Nicola Sorrento invites you and your family to join us for some of Delmarva's best authentic Italian cuisine. Experience the aroma of warm bread served at your table in a cozy atmosphere. Try seafood pescatore or pasta with grandma's gravy. Our New York style pizza and strombolis are a local's favorite. Top it off with cocktails, wine, and dessert. So for great food, good wine, great friends, good times, Villa Sorrento. That's amore. That's a nice.
Not everyone wants a big funeral. For those seeking a simple alternative, the Eastern Shore's most trusted family and funeral service offers another option. Eastern Shore Cremation and Funeral Service is simple and affordable. A direct cremation tribute starts at just $15.95, or choose to have a small visitation service, serving Delaware, Maryland, and Virginia with easy consultation by phone and streamlined electronic documentation. Learn more at easternshorecremation.com. Eastern Shore Cremation and Funeral Services, simply respectful.
Take your career to the next level with a company that truly cares about their employees. Family-owned and operated for over 50 years, Brazier's Pest Control is looking to add full-time service technicians and clerical staff to join their team. Why Brazier's? Competitive pay, weekends and nights off, no holidays and full benefits package. Plus, each technician gets their own fully equipped vehicle. Brazier's Pest Control is committed to providing a healthy work environment, ongoing training, and quality service. If you have what it takes to join Brazier's team, call and set up your interview today.
But when I decided to have my kitchen done, I knew I wanted it done professionally. And that's when I contacted Ellen. She took me to the Delmarva Design Center.
From the moment I bring a customer into Delmarva Design Center, the ideas start to flow. First thing we do is take a stroll around the showroom so we can look at all the different vignettes to get ideas of what they like and see what they react to.
For each of the different aspects that I wanted to change in my kitchen, there were experts here, and everyone was so helpful. They listened to what I had to say, and they had great ideas that helped me put together exactly what I wanted for my kitchen.
My goal is to have the customer enjoy their space as quickly as possible, and Delmarva Design Center helps me do that.
My kitchen is one of my favorite places now. It's something that I use every single day of my life. I'm elated with my experience at the Delmarva Design Center.
Delmarva Design Center. Great design starts with great inspiration. Selbyville, Delaware.
The Fenwick Island Environmental Committee has announced its annual Earth Day Beta Beach cleanup scheduled for Saturday, April 20th. If you want to help, just meet at Town Hall at 8:30 a.m. that morning. Organizers say there will be refreshments, educational materials, and an appreciation gift and cleanup materials. That's also where street and beach cleanup assignments will be provided. The cleanup will be held until 10 a.m.
It's not new danger, but despite efforts to raise awareness about the risks of TVs and furniture tipping over, thousands of children are still sent to the emergency room each year.
That's according to new data released by the U.S. Consumer Product Safety Commission, and it's not only the youth who are at risk.
In today's Health Minute, Mandy Gaither shows us how to help keep your loved ones safe.
Pick out all your jammies.
It can happen in an instant. Curious children climbing on furniture with dangerous consequences.
When you have something that's heavy falling on a child, it can result in death.
In a new report, the U.S. Consumer Product Safety Commission says nearly 18,000 people are hurt in tip-over incidents every year.
Children are impacted more than anybody else. So over the last 10 years, there have been over 200 deaths associated with tip-overs.
Of those deaths, the report says nearly half involved a television, and more than half of those involved children between 1 and 3 years old. But others are at risk, too. The research shows more adults ages 60 and above are also being sent to the emergency room after furniture tipped over. All clothing storage furniture manufactured after September 1st, 2023 has to meet updated safety measures laid out by the CPSC. But no matter when your furniture was made, the agency says it should be anchored to the wall.
You go to the hardware store and for less than $20, you can go back and anchor it into the wall in about 20 minutes.
The website anchorit.gov has step-by-step instructions and videos on how to secure furniture to help prevent a tragedy. For Health Minute, I'm Mandy Gaither.
Delmarva Sports Network from the Wawa Studios.
If you love three-pointers, because who doesn't, you're going to enjoy what happened tonight between Saints Peter and Paul and Delmarva Christian and Boys Hoops. Let's head to Georgetown. Royals down 34-33 at the half. Not anymore. Ed Higgins cans the triple. Other end of the floor, get familiar with the name Garrett Hemingway. A game-high 13 points in the first half for him. Now on the board in first of the second. He wasn't the only one hitting from range for the Sabres. Braden Smith feeling it in this one. Very next trip down the floor, Hemingway sends it over to Smith. Then Zachary Ingham wants to turn himself wetter than Usher during the halftime show right there. Delmarva Christian needs a timeout. Out of the break, whole different Royals. First up, Malachi Light letting it rain from the corner. Royals back down by 7. Next possession, Casey Bell kicks it over to Light. But back to Bell for the 3, and it's a 4-point game. And more from the Royals. Xavier Effort wants a try, and all of a sudden, we've got a 1-point game. But then Smith says, all right, let's get a hold on this thing. Pulls up from way back in Easton, and there's some nylon. Sabres have some breathing room. Fourth quarter, the only time the Sabres trailed was before this bucket. Aaron Ewing, layups good. Saints, Peter and Paul finished with Smith putting in 13 and Hemingway getting 32 points as the Sabres win it 69-60. That'll do it for sports. Have a great night.
Competition heating up in Long Neck. How you can try an array of delicious chili for a good cause. Stay tuned on Coast TV News at 11.
Uncover the perfect blend of comfort, innovation, and safety at Gateway Subaru. And right now, it's your choice. Choose what fits your lifestyle and budget. Choose to lease a new 2024 Subaru Forester for only $299 a month, or take advantage of financing rates as low as 2.9%. Choose to lease a new 2024 Subaru Outback for only $299 a month, or take advantage of financing rates as low as 1.9%. Gateway Subaru, where every choice leads to a new adventure. Love, it's what makes a Subaru a Gateway Subaru. Higher standards.
Did you know incomplete insulation jobs cause more problems than they solve? Adding insulation without air sealing and ensuring proper ventilation can cause mold, discomfort, and potential fire hazards with old wiring. For as little as $100, an energy audit and a blower door test can identify these problems ahead of time, so you don't get any surprises during or after the job.
If your insulation contractor isn't proving their work through testing, it's unlikely that any of these issues are being addressed.
For more information on FLC Energy, visit DelmarvaExperts.com.
Hey, bath guy, do you do roofs?
Nope.
Do you do lawns?
Negatory.
Do you do windows and siding?
Not a chance.
At Peninsula Bath, we're your local pros for bathroom remodeling, and that's it. Top quality, customer focus, and competitively priced. Ask about our free shower door upgrade and our neediest bathroom contest.
Hey, Dad, can you take out the trash?
No, son, not a chance.
Peninsula Bath.
Flu season brings the constant caroling of sneezing, sniffling, and whining children. 30% of people infected with influenza do not know it, making it easy to infect others, especially young children. Your best shot? A flu vaccination for yourself and those you love. Your Dachshund offers flu shots 7 days a week, no appointment needed. Flu shots for veterans are always free. Get your flu shot today. Your Dachshund, in partnership with Title Health.
I'm Nathan Hudson from Laurel, and I utilize the USDA's Wetland Reserve Easement Program to improve water quality and wildlife habitat on my farm. Wetlands improve water quality by filtering sediments and chemicals while providing food and shelter for wildlife. If you have at least 10 acres, you may be eligible for 75% or more of the fair market value and restoration costs for placing an easement on your wooded or ag lands. To learn more about this program, stop by your local USDA service center.
Put your taste buds to the test and warm up with a whole selection of chili on Saturday. A third annual chili contest is happening at the Paradise Pub from 12 to 2. That's on Long Neck Road. Proceeds benefit the Indian River Volunteer Fire Company. It only costs a $5 donation to get into this event and try the competing recipes. Contestants have yet to be announced.
Let's take a look at our winner. Michael Rayan of Ocean View, Delaware. Congratulations, courtesy of Paul Davis Restoration Home Remodeling, courtesy of our Umbrella Giveaway. So, hey, Not bad at all. Our tidal health Seaford camera right now, we have the winds out of the north with temperature of 42 degrees. Our expectation for the rest of the night, we're going to see hit and miss spot showers continue to be the rule of the night, not day, but night, obviously. We have a first alert morning, okay, because we have a coastal flood warning in effect for all of Sussex, along with gale wind warnings. Now, the gale wind warnings, we're talking about 45 mile per hour winds. With the flooding, that means it's going to happen and we can't avoid it, particularly near the bay communities, as well as those folks who are located along the coast. Wind advisors also in effect for some inland areas and right along the coastal region, bracing for about, 30 mile per hour winds. And of course, coastal flood statements in effect for Dorchester as well. Here's a look at your Paul Davis Restoration Home Remodeling exclusive 10-day forecast.
Thank you, Paul, and thank you for joining us on Coast TV News at 11. For more news, for more local weather, download our Coast TV News app.
The Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon is up next. We'll see you tomorrow for Coast TV News at 5 a.m. Have a great night.